Expo, and I want to thank the caucus for helping to make this happen as well. It is an exciting time to be in this space. I sort of got started in renewables a long time ago in the early 90s working on a carbon fiber solar car that my engineering student colleagues and I built that we raced across the United States from Dallas to Minneapolis. But even before that, I grew up in a utility family. So I literally grew up drawing pictures of ready kilowatt for my dad, who was a lineman, and really was taught about things like demand management as early as the mid-1970s with the challenges we had then. And I can tell you that it is absolutely amazing to me to see where we are today, because things have changed so much from the kind of utility reality that my father lived every day, where you had big generation on one end and a one-way street across big transmission and distribution, and then homes and businesses bought energy but didn't produce energy, to the kind of multi-directional grid that we have today. And I think one of the most amazing things that we've seen is that for the first time, you know, we are seeing geographic areas say, we're going to go 100% clean energy. And 10 years ago, I would have said, technologically, you just can't do that. But with the costs coming down the way they have, with the technology coming on the way it has, and with storage making such enormous leaps forward, I think we are at the verge of seeing a radically different grid that is primarily, if not entirely, clean energy in our lifetimes. And that is really an amazing thing. Now, there are a million hurdles between here and there, not the least of which is resources. But the fact is that you can see that on the horizon is a truly momentous change for our country and our planet. I am pleased to be on the Energy and Natural Resources Committee. I'm working on a number of initiatives around things like a storage standard, a investor-owned utility storage standard, very similar to what we're seeing being implemented California right now. That'll be important for incorporating higher levels of clean power and intermittent power into the grid, but it's also incredibly important for things like resiliency and disaster response, and making sure that sometimes you can invest a little more in storage and you don't have to build the big transmission lines in the first place. So we are working hard on that. We're working with Senator Angus King on his distributed generation efforts as well. We're working very hard on transmission siting issues and have some legislation around that. And we're seeing this space change incredibly rapidly. And we need to adjust. We need to set policy that's thinking about the next 20 years and not the last 100 years. So it's great that you all are all thinking about that too. We have huge climate challenges in front of us, obviously. But I believe that we have not only the technology, but the human capital, including in this room, to solve the world's biggest challenges. So let's get to work. Hey.